In question 12, we need to find the peak current and the average power dissipated in the circuit. Solution 12. So, A, peak power, peak current will be E naught by Z. Now, E naught is 50 volt and Z can be obtained by this formula. R square plus X square, that is 300 square plus 10 to the power 4 over 25 square. So after solving this, we will get 0.1 ampere. B part, average power dissipated. So average power dissipated will be Vrms or Erms into Irms cos phi. It can be E naught by root 2 or V naught by root 2. Then E naught by root 2 root 2 Z, this is I, okay, I naught, and cos phi is R by Z. So putting all the values, average power will come 1.5 watt. In 13, what should be the inductance of coil for which the bulb gets correct voltage? Solution 13. So voltage drop across the resistor will be IR, which will be this 220 into 220 over 220 square plus 100 pi L whole square. It will give us 110. This is the voltage drop. Now 220 into 2 equal to root 220 square plus 100 pi L whole square. So from here L will come out to be 1.2135. In 14, find RMS current, RMS potential across capacitor, resistor and inductor. Solution 14. A part. So I naught will be, peak current will be E naught by Z. And it is E naught by root R square plus XC minus XL whole square. So ultimately when we put all the values, we will find that I naught will come 0.1 ampere. B part, potential difference across capacitor, resistor and inductor. So across capacitor, across resistor and across inductor, it will be I naught into XC, I naught into R, I naught into XL, which will give us 50 volt, 30 volt, 10 volt, RMS potential will be 50 volt. Net voltage drops will be 50 plus 30 plus 10, 90 volt. In 15, find the average electric field energy stored in the capacitor and magnetic field energy stored in the coil, that is inductor. Solution 15. So the energy stored in the capacitor will be half CV square and magnetic energy stored in the inductor will be half Li naught square. So this can be V naught. So we can put the values 50 square and half 1.1 square. So this will give us 25 millijoule and this will give us 5 millijoule. In 16, we need to find the frequency to maximize current and value of maximum current. Solution 16. फॉर मैक्सिमम करंट कैपेसिटिव इंडक्टेंस एंड इंडक्टिव कैपेसिटिव इंपीडेंस एंड इंडक्टिव इंपीडेंस शुड बी इक्वल. सो ओमेगा एल इक्वल टू 1 बाय ओमेगा सी, ओमेगा स्क्वायर इक्वल टू 1 बाय एल सी. सो ओमेगा विल बी 10 टू द पावर 3 बाय 6, 2 पाई न्यू विल बी 10 टू द पावर बाय 6. सो फ्रीक्वेंसी विल बी अराउंड 27 हर्ट्ज. एंड दिस इज ए पार्ट एंड बी पार्ट. मैक्सिमम करंट ई बाय आर 20 बाय 10 इंटू 10 टू द पावर 3 2 मिली एम्पियर. When maximum current is there, then Z is equal to R. In 17, when frequency of source is varied, maximum RMS current is 6 ampere. So if what will be the current if inductor coil is connected to battery of EMF 12 volt? Solution 17. E by I 24 by 6 4 ohms. So current will be 12 by 8 because 4 is of internal resistance, so 1.5 ampere. In question 18, this figure is given to us. Now find the output voltage for the given values. Solution 18. So first thing to find is I naught. So I naught will be E naught by Z, and E naught or V is 10 to the power minus 3. And Z is R square plus X square, that is 10 to the power 6 plus 5000 over pi whole square. So once we simplify this, we will obtain the current. And then we need to find VO, which is I naught XC. So this this is the current. And now into XC, XC is 5000 by pi. So it will be around 1.6 millivolt. Then V naught in this scenario. So again over 10 to the power 6 plus 50 over pi square. So in this case it is 50 by pi, which is around 0.16 millivolt. And then V naught I naught into XC, here it will be 10 to the power 6 5 by pi, right? 5 by pi, which will give us around 16 microvolt. In 19, what will be the voltage across the secondary? Solution 19. So transformer works on induction. DC is supplied, so there will be no induction. So in secondary coil, induced EMF will be zero. Therefore induced current will be zero because it is DC. We need AC for induction.